Page 66, exercise 2.1, question 1. A ball pen making company wants to know the relation between price in rupees and supply in 1000 units of its most selling gel pen. The following information is collected for it. Draw a scatter diagram and interpret. Price rupees market as X. There are two variables. Independent variable we always market as X. Monthly supply 1000 units market as Y. Any confusions with this? Supply depends on price. So supply is dependent variable, that is Y. Price is independent variable, that is X. Any confusions? Means in our graph, price will be shown on horizontal x-axis, supply will be shown on vertical y-axis. Now in price, what is the minimum? 11. Maximum? 17. So we can take scale of 1 centimeter, 1 unit. We can directly start with 11. And we'll write from 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 up till 17. In supply, what is the minimum? 12. Maximum? 53. So we take 1 centimeter as 5 units. 5, 10, we'll directly start from 5 and up till 55. Any confusion with that? So, first give the heading, scatter diagram showing, question 1, scatter diagram showing correlation between price and supply. Okay, now y-axis, x-axis, on x we will show price in bracket rupees. On y-axis we will show monthly supply in bracket 1000 units. Any confusions with this? Now see, understand this concept, then you can continue writing it. Put your pens down and you will just understand one point. See, minimum is 11, maximum is 17. So there are two ways of writing it. Suppose you take the scale of 2, then you can simply write 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, and maximum is 17, so we'll write up there. What is the scale we take here? 1 centimeter is 2 rupees. And so we start also directly with 2. Another alternative is, you take the scale of 1. What is the minimum value? You directly start with 11. So 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, and 17. Got it, everyone? But earlier what scale did we take? 2. And we started also with 2. Now what scale we are taking?
1.
But do we start with 1?
No.
So here you will break the line and you will do this kind of a sign. So like if you are having a string with you and you squeeze it, how does it appear? So 1 to 10 all are included. We squeeze that. If we would have started with 1 itself, then this breaking the line is not. Okay, like earlier we started with 2, scale is also 2, then breaking the line was not needed. Got it, everyone? Any confusion with this concept? See, in Y we will not break the line. What is the scale we are intending to take on Y?
5.
And we start also with 5. So there you need not break the line. Directly you can start with 5 up till 5. Any confusions with that? Right. And here on the top right hand corner you will mention the scale which we have taken. On X it says 1 centimeter equals to rupees 1. Okay, it's rupees and we have taken 1 unit only. On Y axis, 1 centimeter equals to, we have taken 5 and you can see here it's in 1000 units. So 5000 units. Understood that, everyone? Here is 1 centimeter, 1 rupees, here is 5, but the units are in thousands. So here 1 centimeter actually indicates 5000 units. This is 5000, 10,000, 15,000 and so on. Raise your hand who did not understand the scales. Who are us writing it? Everyone has plotted the points. Shall I start with the diagram? Raise your hand, we're still writing it. So I'll start with it, okay? Now it's very simple. First value, can you see 14 and 32? 14 of price is directly available. Can you all see that? But 32 of supply is not directly available. So between 30 to 35, you can say this is 31, 32, 33, 34, 35. Roughly, we have just marked it approximately. And out of that, so this would be 32, 14 and 32, where do they intersect? There you have to mark the dot and circle it so that it's visible. Because if people are doing it with pencil, in exams it may not be easily visible, the dots. So we circle them so that they are easily visible. Raise your hand who is not clear with 14 and 32 intersection. So I'll not explain the rest, I'll directly plot the rest of the points. Everyone is clear with 14 and 32? See, next is 16 and 50. 16 directly available, 50 also directly available. So wherever 16 and 50 intersect, straight away you mark the dot and circle it. Okay? Then 12 and 20. 12 is directly available, 20 also directly available. So wherever they intersect, dot and circle. Raise your hand who is not able to follow. Then 11 and 12. 11 directly available, but 12 after 10. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So 12 would be approximately here. Okay? 11 and 12 is intersection. Anyone who did not understand this? In exams, if they ask you this question and provide the graph paper, then perfectly you get the points. On the graph paper, you get the points perfectly. Okay? 15 and 45. 15 we have, 45 also we have. So directly their intersection can be obtained. Then 13 and 50. 13 and 50 both are exactly available. And last is 17 and 53. 53 means after 50, 51, 52, 53, 54 and 55. So 53 is here. 17 and 53. Do you all get this kind of a diagram? 13 and
30.
Sorry, I marked it 15. 13 and 30 would be here. Okay, 13 and 30. Is everyone able to get this kind of a diagram? Now, we studied yesterday 5 scattered diagrams. Perfect positive, perfect negative, partial positive, partial negative, no linear correlation. Which one does this look like? Partial positive. That conclusion we have to write. So, below that diagram, you mention thus. Below the diagram mentioned, we don't write inside the diagram. Thus, there is partial positive correlation between price and supply. Below the diagram, you must write this statement. So, has everyone understood this? Any confusions? So, question 2, we'll decide this scale and solve it. Okay? Anyone still solving with the first one? Amita Dutra? Raise your hand who is still solving the first one. So, look at question 2. A company manufactures RO plants for the factories. The information about the advertisement cost for its sale and its profit from the sale of RO plants is given below. Advertisement cost you'll mark it as X. Profit you'll mark it as Y. What is the minimum RO cost? Sorry, advertisement cost? 5. Maximum? So like, what will we take the scale? 11. What will we take the scale? 1 unit only. And we can directly start with 5. You'll create this line. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11. In case of Y axis, what is the minimum? 7. Maximum? So there also we'll break the line. We'll start directly with 7 and keep the scale of 1. So 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 and... Is everyone clear with this? Draw a scatter diagram from this information and state the nature of relationship between the advertisement cost and profit earned from the sale of RO plants. So you ready? Question 2. Scatter diagram showing correlation between advertisement and profit. On x-axis we will show advertisement cost in bracket. What are the units? 10,000 rupees and profit lakh rupees. So what we'll do on x-axis, we'll directly start with 5. You'll break the line and then 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and up till 11. Any conclusions? Same way, on y axis the minimum is 7, so we directly start with 7 and right up till 13. Here also you break the line 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And here you mention scale. On x axis, what do we write? 1 centimeter equals to 10,000. We have taken 1 centimeter, 1 unit, but what is the unit? 10,000. So 1 here means rupees 10,000. And on y-axis, 1 centimeter is equal to 1 lakh rupees. Here the unit is in lakhs. So rupees 1 lakh. One more minute for plotting the points. Do it fast. 1. All of you have completed? Now see here, what is the first point we have to mark the intersection? 5 and 8. So on x-axis we directly have 5 available. And 8 is also directly available. So 5 and 8's intersection. Getting it everyone? Next one is 6 and 7's intersection. Next is 7 and 9's intersection. Next is 8 and 10's intersection. 9 and 13's intersection. 10 and 12's intersection. And 11 and 13's intersection. Do you all get this kind of a diagram? Complete it fast. Kajal? What will we interpret? Partial positive. Is everyone able to understand this? Again, looking at the diagram, we can say it is partial positive. So that statement conclusion you get at the bottom. Thus, there is partial positive correlation between advertisement and profit. So anyone having any conclusions in this? Who all is still solving it? Raise your hand. No one is solving. Everyone has completed, sir. Shall I take up a question 3? Look at question number 3. Generally, practical numerical based questions would be asked. If this comes in exams, you'll be fortunate enough, because it will be 5 marks, you'll be lucky to get directly. So, very less chances, but if it is asked, then you'll be very lucky enough. The following information is collected to study the relationship between the minimum day temperature. Question number 3, okay? And sale of woolen clothes during a particular day of winter for 6 different cities. Minimum day temperature market is X in degrees Celsius, and sale of woolen clothes 1000 units market is Y. Now, what is the minimum value in temperature? 5. Maximum? 24. So, but how shall we take the scale? 2, 4, 6, 8 of the 24. That can also be done. Alternatively, raise your hand. What else can be done with less labor and time? Tanushree, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. Sorry. And Baiju, in case of sale of woolen clothes, minimum is?
Minimum is 8.
8 and maximum is?
70.
70. How can you take the scale? 5, 10, 15, 20 up till 70, or alternatively you can also take?
10.
10, 20, because maximum are in 10 and 5s. So you can take directly 10, 20, 30, 40 up till? 7. Is everyone clear with it? No need to break the line in any of the cases, because we'll be taking the scale of 5 and starting with
5.
We'll be taking the scale of 10 and starting with
10.
Understood that? So, right now, question 3. Scatter diagram showing correlation between temperature and sale of woolen clothes. On x-axis, minimum day temperature in bracket Celsius. On y-axis, sale of woven clothes in bracket 1000 units. Now, we'll be taking from 5 to 25 and 10 to 70. So, no need to break the line. Straight away, you can start with 5, 10, 15, 20 and 25. Here, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60 and 70. You can mention the scale here. On x-axis, 1 centimeter equals to 5 degrees Celsius, and on y-axis, 1 centimeter is equal to 10,000 units. It is 10, but then it's expressed in 1000 units, so 10,000 units. Is everyone clear with this? 1 minute's time completed, everyone. But we have taken scale of 10, so 10,000 units. Okay, if you take scale of 1, 10, 11, 12, 13, then 1000 units. You are taking a gap of. Anyone else having any confusions? Raise your hand, we are still plotting the points. All have plotted the points. Yes, we did. 12 and 35. Now, 12 means, we'll have to get it approximately. Like here you can see 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So this would be 12. And 35 means exactly between 30 and 40. Is everyone able to understand this? So 12 and 35 would be this one, the point of intersection. 20 and 10. 20 is exactly available. 10 is also exactly available. This is the point of intersection. All are able to get it? 8 and 45. Now 8. So 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This one is 8. And 45 means exactly between 40 and 50. So 8 and 45 will intersect here. Able to understand this, everyone? 5 and 70. This one is 5 and 70 is exactly available. So 5 and 70. 15 and 20. This one is 15 and this one is 20. So 15 and 20. 24 and 8. So after 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. This one is 24. And 8 means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This one is 8. 24 and 8 somewhere here. So does everyone get this kind of a diagram? Namrata, what will we interpret? Anuj, what will we interpret? Perfect negative. It's a straight line. Partial negative. Okay, if it's a perfect straight line, then only perfect negative. This is partial negative. Did everyone understand this? So don't write out this. Below the diagram, you write this. There is partial negative correlation between temperature and sale of woolen clothes. Understood this, everyone? So all of you are clear with the first method of correlation scatter diagram method. Illustration 1 to 4 is your homework. TO2. Okay, 1, 2, 3 and 4 is your homework. They are based on scatter diagram. Homework notebook to be maintained separate from classwork notebook. And scales, etc. I leave it on your own to decide. You must be able to decide on your own. Okay. Now what is the limitation of this scatter diagram method? Understand it? We can judge whether it is partial positive or partial negative. But exact value of R, which we will be able to find in Carl Pearson and Spearman's rank correlation, is not obtainable here. Like partial positive, R is always between minus 1 and plus 1. But in partial positive, is it 0.8? Is it 0.9? Is it 0.76? Exact value in scatter diagram cannot be. This is the only limitation. It can be asked for 1 mark in exam in section B. What is the limitation of scatter diagram method? Exact value, exact strength, exact degree of correlation cannot be. Okay. Look at page 66. At the top you'll find merits and limitations. I'm discussing them, you'll learn it and come tomorrow. In between 7:15 to 7:30, between the lecture, you'll be writing it. So look at it, merits. First one. This is a simple method to know the nature of correlation between two variables. It's simple, we have seen it already. And less mathematical knowledge is required, as the knowledge of plotting the points is the only requirement in this method. Calculations are not involved. It also gives some idea about the strength of correlation. For example, like this one, can I say this high degree of positive correlation because the points are close to the straight line? If they are close to the line, high degree, away from the line? So some idea about the degree or strength can be. The scatteredness of the points suggests whether correlation is linear or not, we can find out. And fifth, there is no difficulty in judging the nature. Very easily you can find, is it positive or is it negative? Even if some pairs of extreme observations are present in the limitation, as I discussed, what is the only limitation? Exact degree, strength cannot be obtained. This method gives the nature of correlation and some idea about the strength of correlation, but underline, it does not give exact degree of relationship between two variables. Got it, everyone? So this you will learn and come tomorrow again. Now in the summary where you have left two pages, you will get the idea. Carl Pearson's product moment method. We'll take up to the formulas of Carl Pearson's product moment. Yes, dear reader, you write the formulas along with me so that you don't make any mistake in that and later on don't land up getting a position. First formula, there are six formulas of it. So note it down carefully. First one, write down R is equal to. Okay, we discussed yesterday coefficient of correlation is denoted as R. COV. Covariance between x and y. COV bracket x comma y. And how do you read this as? Covariance between x and y. Upon Sx, standard deviation of x, into Sy, standard deviation of y. We studied standard deviation and variance in the last year. Covariance between x and y means joint variance between x and y. So how is this covariance obtained? Covariance between x and y is equal to sigma x minus x bar, again in bracket y minus y bar upon n. But we'll not be required to find it. We'll be using this formula in short questions where all the three informations are directly given. We just need to apply the formula and put the values. That's it. Okay? We'll not be using it in long questions. We'll be using it only in short questions. Okay? Covariance can be obtained in one more manner, sigma xy minus n x bar y bar upon n. Both will always give you the same answer. And second and third formula we derive from this substitution. When in covariance x and y, we substitute the first formula of covariance, you get the second formula. And when in covariance you substitute the second formula, you get third formula of r. Means, in place of covariance now, I substitute the first formula of covariance, that is sigma x minus x bar, again bracket y minus y bar upon n. What does this stand for? Covariance between x and y. Other than that, what remains in the denominator? S6 into S5. This is the second formula. Did you understand this? In covariance between x and y, I have substituted sigma x minus x bar, y minus y bar upon n. And Sx and Sy remains. Same way, if you substitute the next formula, you get the third one. Raise your hand. What would be the third formula of R? Exactly same way. If you substitute this second formula in covariance, you'll get the third formula of R. Darshan? Correct. Okay, first in covariance, we'll write that. What is the second formula? Sigma xy minus n x bar y bar upon n. What does this indicate? Covariance between x and y. What remains? Sx into s. Did you understand this? Has everyone written the first three formulas? Okay. First three formulas will be used only in short questions where directly the information is means respective formulas we can identify based on the information given and apply the formula. Okay. Next three formulas will be using in long questions as well as short question. So fourth one, write it along with me and listen carefully, see carefully and write it. N sigma xy, n sigma xy minus sigma x into sigma y, n sigma xy minus sigma x into sigma y. Did you write it clear? Upon square root of n sigma x square, n sigma x square minus bracket sigma x bracket close whole square. Okay, n sigma x square minus sigma x whole square. Sigma x square is different and sigma x whole square is different. Again into square root of, same way with y, n sigma y square minus bracket sigma y bracket close whole square. Okay, n sigma x y, check it carefully, minus sigma x into sigma y upon square root of n sigma x square minus sigma x whole square into square root of n sigma y square minus sigma y. Fifth formula, exactly same as fourth. X will be replaced with u and y will be replaced with v. So n sigma u v, x replaced with u, y replaced with v. Minus, what will you get? Sigma x will become?
U.
Sigma u. Sigma y will become?
V.
Sigma v upon square root of, yes, what will you write? N sigma x square now? N sigma u square minus sigma u whole square into square root of n sigma v square minus bracket sigma v whole square. Did you understand this? Now what is this UMV? Last year we studied in mean direct method and short method. What do we use to obtain in short method? D. How do we use to obtain DI? Xi minus A. That is UMV. Last year we had only one variable X, but now we have two variables X and Y. So we cannot denote it as D for both of them, otherwise it will become DD. And which D stands for which deviation of X and Y cannot be asserted. So because there are two variables, instead of denoting it as D, we denote it as u and. So this is like x minus assumed mean and this is like y minus assumed mean. Is everyone up to clear with this? So there is a direct method and this is the short method. But because there are two variables, instead of d we write u and. Any confusions? And the last one. R equals to sigma x minus x bar y minus y bar. R equals to sigma x minus x bar in one bracket, again multiplied by y minus y bar in another bracket, divide by square root of sigma x minus x bar whole square into square root of sigma y minus y bar whole square. Okay, square root of sigma x minus x bar whole square into square root of sigma y minus y bar whole square. Right everyone? These three will be used in long questions as well as short questions. How to use it? I'll discuss it from tomorrow once we start with the questions. Which long question we shall use fourth formula? Means tomorrow we'll practice fourth formula based questions. Day after tomorrow, sixth formula based questions. And two lectures we'll have to devote for fifth formula. This is the most important one. So that we'll see in the coming lectures. Okay. Now as I remember all the six formulas perfectly well, you can also do this miracle. So what you are supposed to do for that is write this 6 formula. So you'll also remember it perfectly well. And again, how to write it 20 times, be careful and listen carefully. First you write, first formula 10 times. R equals to covariance x, y minus s, x, y, covariance x, y minus s, s, y, 10 times. Then you write second formula
10
times. Third formula 10 times, fourth 10 times, fifth 10 times, sixth 10 times. Then 11th time write all the 6. 12th time write all the 6. 13th time write all the 6. So do it in 2 parts. First you write individually 10 times so you remember each formula. Then you write all the 6 10 times so that you perfectly remember and don't get mixed up with the formulas. Did you understand the pattern of doing it? Any conclusions? We can take up with one small question of interpretation. Look at page number 111. Exercise 2, section D, question number 5. Yes, see that. Interpret. Raise your hand. R equals to 1. What do you interpret? R equals to 1. Prashni? Yes, perfect. Positive correlation. What will you interpret for R equals to minus 1? Pushing? Perfect negative correlation. What will you interpret for R equals to 0? Raise your hand. R equals to 0. Rudra? No marks. Raju?
No
linear correlation. Yesterday I discussed with you, if R is 0, don't make a mistake of writing no correlation. What will you write? No?
Linear.
In this chapter, what are we studying?
Linear
correlation. What does R stand for? Linear correlation coefficient. Is everyone clear with it? So written R equals to 1, perfect positive correlation. R equals to minus 1, perfect negative correlation. And R equals to 0, no linear correlation. Understood this, everyone?